everybody. Cosmic Claire at Waking the Monkey on Twitter and Gab. I'm just going to have a short little video on this one tonight. And I just wanted to pick up on a point that someone had made a bit of an error on that I noticed. This was about Jordan Peterson. I think a lot of people will have heard of Jordan Peterson in the last few months. And it's well known that Jordan Peterson has got in trouble with Canadian authorities in the universities and possibly further afield by saying that he will not use the made-up pronouns which have now been mandated by this new Canadian law. Right, now, Jordan Peterson has been misquoted about this, particularly over the instance in which he did a video interview with Theryn Meyer, who is a notable trans YouTuber who is Canadian. And Jordan Peterson was called out by one Mark Collett, who is a voice on the right, and he said that recently in a podcast on Tara McCarthy's channel. I think it, I won't try and give the name, but it was on Tara McCarthy's channel, I don't want to get it wrong. Mark Collett said that Jordan Peterson was a hypocrite because he had said he would not call transgender people by their desired pronoun. This is not what, he said that Jordan Peterson was a hypocrite because he called Theryn Meyer she. He addressed her in the feminine, and Theryn Meyer is a trans person, and therefore Mark Collett said that Jordan Peterson was a hypocrite for saying that he would not use transgender pronouns, and then he went and called Theryn Meyer she. Now, this is entirely a misquote, because what Jordan Peterson said, and I've already said this in the first place, is that Jordan Peterson said that he would not use the made-up pronouns. I think this is a perfectly reasonable position. He, in fact, elaborated on this by saying that freedom of speech was the thing that was here. And he wanted to say that the law, it was bad enough when the law prevented people from saying certain things, but this new law actually said that people had to say certain things. So this is absolutely contrary to freedom of speech. It's not even forbidding certain speech, such as we have here in Europe over certain issues that obviously I can't talk about because they're forbidden. If we actually had to talk about certain things in a certain way, then clearly this is really a kind of dictatorial line on speech, certainly, isn't it, obviously. So that's what he said. He said he would not comply with the conditions that people were obliged to use these made-up pronouns. There's some ludicrous number of them. And when he spoke to Theryn Meyer and referred to her as she, he did so because, firstly, the word she is one of the normal pronouns. And so he spoke to her, calling her she and the addressing her in the feminine, because that was a courtesy that he addressed to her, since she had asked him if he'd be so kind as to say that. At no point did Theryn Meyer ask Jordan Peterson to use made-up pronouns. And I don't think she threatened him with legal action if he didn't use the desired she pronoun either. So basically, this is a misrepresentation, so I have to call this out because I don't agree with everything Jordan Peterson says, just as I don't agree with everything that Mr. Mark Collett says. However, when there are misrepresentations of these things, then I feel that it is important to critique and point out the errors of the misrepresentation, because I know that Mr. Mark Collett is neither keen on Jordan Peterson nor on trans people. So it would seem to me that there has been a little bit of bias and misrepresentation gone in there, and unfortunately, I've found that there are elements within certain right-wing political trends in our society, which are rather authoritarian, and I just think that this is not the way to achieve our sought goals. So I will just wrap it up there. Main thing is no invented pronouns, personal courtesy. Theryn Meyer does come across, I think, to many people, most people, hopefully, in a feminine manner. She does come across as a with a female persona, and that seems to be a fairly consistent state of affairs. So I think that's okay. Righto, so if you liked this, please like, share, subscribe, and please do share this with other people, because I'm trying to get back onto this YouTube wheel of getting some of these ideas out, because transgender is an area in which there is much misrepresentation from both sides of the argument, and I'm trying to find some kind of balanced position in between where we take account of realities. Okay, so thank you very much. As I say, please do like, share, subscribe. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye.